Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, thank you very much for coming here today. This meeting has been organized by the Belgian Committee of Parliamentarians and Majors for a Democratic Iran. We are holding this meeting to highlight the urgent need to react to the brutal human rights violations in Iran. 2 years ago, Hassan Rouhani became president in Iran. He pretended to be different to Ahmadinejad, and many people in the West said that he is moderate and that he is the new Gorbachev. This reality, after 2 years of the presidency of Rouhani, is something else. With 1,600 executions in just 2 years, Iran has the highest number of the executions in the world per capita. They execute many young protesters and political prisoners under the name of drug traffickers. Many women have been brutally repressed. The religious minorities are being persecuted much worse than before. The repression against women is also worse than before. Iranian regime is also sponsoring many Islamic fundamentalists and terrorist groups in the world, and especially in the Middle East. Iran is fully supporting Bashar Assad of Syria, and they supported the Islamic fundamentalists in Yemen, which has resulted to this war in Yemen by an Arab coalition that want to prevent the Iranian regime's expansion. Today, everyone is talking about the nuclear negotiations, but we should not forget that the only reason the mullahs have accepted to negotiate is because of the international pressure and especially because of the sanctions. We believe that any expansion of relationship with Iran must be conditioned to a very clear progress in the field of human rights. This is what the people of Iran expect from us in Europe. As elected representatives of our people in Europe, we should not forget the democracy and human rights because of business and trade or a nuclear deal. Last week, the leader of the Iranian Democratic Opposition, Mrs. Maryam Rajavi, was invited to speak as a witness in an official hearing of the US Congress Foreign Affairs Committee in Washington, D.C. Some of the members of Congress said that it was a historical event, as the Congress for the first time was listening to the voice of the Iranian opposition. She stressed very clearly that the Iranian regime is the godfather of the so-called Islamic State or ISIS, and that it has been the main source of exporting extremism and fundamentalism to the region. She said it would be very wrong to make coalition with Iran to fight ISIS. Her appearance got huge attention in the international press, and I congratulated her and the Iranian resistance for this success. I am sure that you agree that the situation in Iran and in the region will be very different if we have Mrs. Rajavi as the leader of Iran instead of these Ayatollahs. She is an advocate of gender equality, separation between religion and state, rights for minorities, and abolition of torture and death penalty. I hope we can work together to help the Iranian resistance to express its views and have a dialogue with our governments in Europe. I encourage our government here, as well as the EU High Representative, start a dialogue with the National Council of Resistance of Iran. This dialogue would help us to make better decisions for the future of Iran. Thank you very much.